In this video, we will cover logistic regression, including the need for logistic regression, the logistic regression model, and odds, ratios, and prediction. In many instances, when you're testing hypotheses and making predictions, you'll have dichotomous outcomes. For example, in a game, you can either win or lose. On a website, a user either clicks or does not click. In an election, a person votes for a candidate or does not. When the outcome variable is categorical, such as our game example, it does not follow a normal distribution. The outcome variable is a probability, measured between 0 and 1. The estimates you make should be numbers in that range. A linear model cannot be applied. We need a nonlinear function. There are many nonlinear models we can choose from to fit our data. Some nonlinear functions are shown here. The last one shown is the logistic function. That will fit the data the best because it has an upper and lower bound. Here's a logistic regression model in orange versus a linear regression model in blue. Isn't it a better fit for the data? To best suit our data, we want a model that predicts probabilities between 0 and 1, so it will be S-shaped. There are lots of S-shaped curves, but the logistic regression model is what we'll use in this instance. The logistic function is a nonlinear function of independent variables. However, we can convert this nonlinear function into a linear relationship using the log of the odds ratio. Note that instead of modeling just zeros and ones, we're modeling the probability of an event occurring. With the logistic regression model, instead of winning or losing, we build a model for log odds of winning or losing. It's a natural logarithm of the odds of the outcome. P stands for the probability of the outcome, while 1 minus P stands for the probability of not getting an outcome. However, having log of P over 1 minus P on the y-axis is not very helpful. We have to compute the actual odds. To do that, we have to use the exponential functions. Let's look at a very simple example of a logit function. Does alcohol drinking predict political party? Political party is the outcome variable, and it is binary. Therefore, we need a logistic regression. A typical logit equation contains the log of the odds ratio as the outcome, which is a linear function of the predictor's x. The logit model to measure the impact of drinking on voter choice is going to be set up as follows. The log of the odds ratio will be measured from data on x, where x here is the number of drinks per week. It's really important to understand that negative 1.4 is measuring the log of the odds ratio. In other words, it is the log of the probability of being Republican divided by the probability of not being a Republican. To get the actual odds ratio, you have to compute the exponent, which is equal to 0.25. Since the odds are less than 1, it tells us that the more you drink, the lower your odds of being Republican. All of these calculations can be done automatically in SAS, but it's important to understand the math behind what SAS is doing. The same model can be extended to more than one variable. We just add more predictors to the equation. The coefficient beta measures the impact of x on the log of the odds ratio. For example, in linear regression, if y equals 2 plus 3x, a 1-unit increase in x will increase y by 3 units. In a logistic regression, log p over 1 minus p minus 2 plus 3x shows us that if x increases by 1 unit, then the log odds of p, y equals 1, increases by 3 units. The impact on the odds ratio is represented by e exponent beta. We can also compute probabilities directly. To compute odds, we have to use the exponent. If we don't want to look at odds, but the actual probabilities, we apply the entire logistic function formula as shown in this probability function. These are the odds ratios and log of odds ratios for various probabilities. An important point to understand is how the odds ratios are tied to the probabilities. Note the mathematical equivalencies. A 50% probability, or probability of 0.5, is the same as 1-to-1 odds. The log of the odds ratio at that point is equal to 0. As probability increases, odds ratio increases from 0 to infinity, while the log of the odds ratio can become any value. This concludes our video on logistic regression. Today we covered the need for logistic regression, the logistic regression model, and odds ratios and prediction.